Some of the nurses at the front line of the battle against COVID-19 have gone on strike today. Thousands of nurses and workers across 500 primary healthcare facilities downed tools demanding pay parity with their district health board counterparts. Eva Corlett reports.
Nurses working in general practices to emergency centres across the motu took to the streets today to rally support for their plight. Some of them are those tasked with swabbing for COVID-19. In Hamilton, a group of workers wove banners declaring that quality work needs quality pay.
Practice nurses are paid 10% less than our colleagues who work in the hospital. And that just seems very unfair. We recognise that they work very hard, but so do we.
We're doing a lot in proactively promoting health to keep them out, people out of hospital.
We're a very talented group of nurses, and we are not recognised for the skills that we have.
I think we've just rolled over for so long and just got on with it,
yeah.
Because of our passion for and love for nursing.
That's right.
And we're all equally qualified as the DHB.
What we want is for the government to step up and appreciate our skills and give us pay parity with the DHB.
In Christchurch, practice nurse Sarah Watkey says staff are working to the bone on the COVID-19 response front lines.
The lack of value that has been given to us actually brings me to tears. It's like, why did we have to work through that if they're not going to show us that we have value?
Christchurch nurse Sole Tuatope, who works with a lot of Māori and Pacifica patients, says it's only fair that community practices should be paid equally.
DHBs expect care to be in the community, to be placed in the homes, and they need to reflect that in our pay scales. So we've been kept quiet for a long time. DHBs did get a solid pay rise in the last lot of negotiations, and yet we're still way behind.
In Dunedin, nurse Andrea Buxton says it's time primary healthcare workers were recognised.
We talk to our colleagues in the DHB. They work hard as well. They earn 10%, at least 10% more than what we do, and we do the same work.
Another Dunedin nurse, Suzanne Crisado, resents being treated differently from others in her field.
We get a nice little letter with a pat on the back from the Minister of Health saying, oh, you did a nice job. Thank you very much for all the work that you put in during COVID. That was so demeaning. It was absolutely demeaning to get that after all the work that we did. And we had to do it while we did everything else. How insulting. The hospital seems to think that they can ditch work onto us and that we will just accept it. There's no extra money that comes for it. Our workplaces are under stress. Everybody's caving. And then you add COVID on top of it. Why shouldn't we be paid exactly the same as everybody else?
In Wellington, lead nurses' organisation advocate Chris Wilson told a crowd gathered outside Parliament that the situation is unacceptable.
The frustration and anger and disrespect you must all be feeling for not being heard after 1 year of fruitless negotiations is just not acceptable. What do you have to do to be recognised? You're the front door of health.
The Director General of Health, Dr. Ashley Bloomfield, says primary care workers and admin staff are critical to the COVID-19 response.
The main issue here and what's causing concern for these primary care staff is that a gap has opened up between their own pay rates and those of DHB employed nursing and administrative staff, and it's understandable that they are concerned about that and are looking for a solution to address that gap.
Dr. Bloomfield says he is working with the Ministry and DHBs to come to a solution. The nurses' organisation is urging those groups to meet with primary care employers before the next strike in 2 weeks' time. Mō te hōtaka o te ahiahi nei, ko Eva Corlett tēnei.